find the social cues on when to speak are lost when communicating on screen, so I'll often hesitate to offer input in group scenarios.
Not being able to see the person's face in an online tutorial makes it quite challenging for me to engage with them in a conversation.
I struggled to form new friendships at university with online classes. Meeting someone through a screen feels so impersonal, so it's been hard to form those genuine connections with people.
When sending a message, I find that it's harder to express everything like I would have face to face, and so my messages have become more refined.
I find it denaturalizing. I'm a tactile person. I want to hug people, I want to shake people's hand. And all this is gone.
I'm a very emotional communicator. I like to use my hands a lot and touch people. It comes from my Greek heritage. So for me, it's very difficult not to be able to kiss somebody I'm seeing for the first time after a long time.
Well, when I see my friends at uni, communication can get hard, especially with social distancing. And if I'm not allowed to hug them, it can just get a bit awkward sometimes.
Social distancing has made it hard when I meet someone now. I don't know whether I can shake their hand, do we bump elbows? It's certainly challenging, and at times it's definitely a little awkward.
Before the COVID-19 era, we may have taken our social interactions for granted as something that we just did, something that came naturally and felt natural. But now we can all relate to the impact of voice and video chat on our confidence in communicating, and we can relate more genuinely to the 1.2 million Australians who have a communication disability and who might not feel confident to communicate every day of their lives. Speech Pathology Australia Week seeks to promote the speech pathology profession and the wonderful work done by speech pathologists with many of these 1.2 million people.